Good morning, friends. Welcome back to biology online classes. Actually, we are discussing about heredity and evolution. Under that, we have discussed the evidences of evolution. Under that, we have seen morphological evidences, and also we have seen anatomical evidences. We are going to discuss another important evidence of evolution is embryological evidence. So, what is that embryological evidence, and how they are useful for us? That we will discuss right now. So, embryological evidence. Embryological evidence. So, already we know that what is embryological evidences, what is embryology. So, embryology is one of the branch of biology that helps in study the various developmental stages of embryo. Understand? So, as you have seen, in the process of reproduction, the single celled zygote undergoes division and to finally reaches a young one stage. Understand? So, in between the changes which is occurred during embryonic development stages, if you observe all the vertebrates, like amphibians, reptiles, or apes, mammals, whatever it is, if you observe all the vertebrates, they consisting of some common characteristics, that is the thing, during early embryonic development stage. Understand? So, earlier embryonic development stage, so these vertebrates, they consisting of common characteristic features which are found, but later on may present or may not present. That is secondary. But what you have to see is during embryonic development, all the embryos are consisting of some common characteristics. That is the one thing. And also this shows some of the developmental stages are similar during embryonic development. Understand? So, what is the embryology means? Embryology is the branch of biology and what is the use of this biological branch? This helps to study the various developmental stages of embryo. Understand? So, what is embryology means? It is a branch of biology and which is essential to know the various developmental stages of the embryo. That's why it is one of the important. And if you observe, according to embryology, even though the morphological means the appearance structures, morphological means what? The physical appearance structures of all the vertebrates embryo, all are similar. There is no any changes. Understand? During early embryonic development, the morphological structure is similar. During the embryo of all vertebrates, morphologically similar. Understand? That is a very important thing. So, morphologically they are similar. And one more thing is, they possess or they consisting of some common characteristics. They possess some common characteristics. Understand? That is one more thing. They consisting of some common characteristics. So, and one more thing is, what you have to remember is, they are consisting of some similar development stages also. Understand? So, embryonic developmental stages. Stages are similar. Understand? That is one more thing we have to see. So, what are the things we have to remember is sir, what is going to happen here is they are structurally similar during embryonic development stage. That is one thing, and the process they consisting of some common characteristic features. That is a thing, and they were embryologically similar, means their structure is similar during embryonic development. That's what the three important characteristic features we can observe during early embryonic development stage of all the vertebrate animals. And so that is the thing we have to remember. And let us see how the structure is similar. And if you observe, for example, what do we say? They were structurally similar during embryonic development stage. You said, is it or not? See, if you observe here, during embryonic development stage, they were structurally similar. For example, this is fish embryo. And this is, we can take a chick embryo. And this is the human beings, man's embryo. And this we can take as frog. Or suppose. And if you observe, during embryonic development stage, all the embryos are whether fish or chick or it is man or maybe it is frog. Any organism if you take from vertebrates, they were similar to appear. So it is difficult to distinguish which embryo is belongs to which organism. Understand? That's what it is very difficult to identify. So what it says that all the embryos are similar means what we can say? We all are having common ancestor. We are originated from one common living organism. That is the thing you have to remember. So we all are originated from common ancestor. That is the thing we have to get from this diagrammatic showing. Understand? So by this embryological diagrammatic representation of embryos, that gives an idea about that all the embryos which are structurally similar, that says that all the vertebrates are having common ancestor. Understand? How do we know it is we have common ancestor? We know that the structural similarity is there. So this is the first condition what we have seen. And let us see one next condition. And second condition, what you said, they consisting of common characteristic features. What are the common characteristic features are found? See, the presence of gill plates are found in all the organisms, even though in human beings also found the gill plates earlier embryonic development. That is the thing. And formation of tail. This tail also formed during embryonic stage.
That is the thing.
And also we can see the formation of nervous system. Nervous system is also one of the common characteristics which is found in all the vertebrates. And notochord. So notochord, which is later on replaced or developed into spinal cord. Understand? So the gill plates, the tail, nervous system, as well as notochord, these all are the organs are found in all the vertebrates. Means what we can get an idea is we have one common ancestor. So we all are originated from one common ancestor. That is the thing we have to remember. Understand? And one more thing we have seen. So what do we say? Embryo of all organisms are morphologically similar, we said. We have seen diagrams. And they possess some common characteristics. Means they have common characteristics like tail, notochord, nervous system, as well as gill plates presence. That is the thing. And the developmental stages. That is the thing we have to remember. So, developmental stages, under that, now let us see the developmental stages. So, in the reproduction concept, we have discussed that the fusion of male and female gamete, it leads to the formation of a single cell structure. What do we call as a zygote? It's right. So, zygote formed. This zygote is single cell, is it right? This single cell, which is formed by the fusion of a male and female gamete, as we know, this zygote during developmental stages, it undergoes to form several celled or a mass of cell structure called morula. Means it consisting of group of cells. It is consisting of group of cells are found. So single cell is divided into to form as a morula, which consisting of a ball like structure or the mass of cells. Understand? That is what we call morula. This morula stage undergoes into blastula phase. What do we call as a blastula phase? The blastula phase is characterized by presence of two germline membrane. What is present? Two germline membrane. As we have seen that during embryonic development, the organs development also going to occur. So from which germ membrane the organs are going to develop, that is decided by this germline. Understand? So it is two germline. Two germline structure it is, and this undergoes further cell division and which forms as three germline structure called as gastrula, which is consisting of three germline membranes. From these germline membrane we can see the origin of different organ systems are going to develop. Understand? That is what we can see. From the zygote, the morula, morula to blastula, blastula to gastrula, and finally it is young one. And these all are the phases which we can see the formation of commonly in all the vertebrates. Understand? That's what the embryology is one of the evidence that makes it clear that we have a common ancestor. That's why these all are the things are commonly found in all the vertebrates. Understand? In this way we can see embryology is also one of the very very essential tool for knowing the evidences of evolution. Is it done? So this is what embryological evidences what do we have. Understand? So it is just we can recall. So what is embryology means? It is a branch of science from biological science. And what it does, it study the various developmental stages of young ones. Understand? From the embryo. That is called as embryology. According to the embryology, all the vertebrates, they consisting of some characteristics. That is, the morphological structure appearance is similar. in embryonic development stage, and they consisting of common characteristics, that is one more thing, and the various developmental stages are same in all the vertebrates, what we have seen. Understand? See, what that we have seen is the first, all the morphological structure appearing similar. That's what, even though it is smallest to huge animal, but their embryos are similar, which is we can't identify whose embryo it is. Understand? That's what it is gives the evidence, is that we have a common ancestor. That is the thing. And the common characteristics are like presence of gill plates, that is one thing, presence of tail, and presence of nervous system, and presence of notochord. These are the commonly found characteristics in all the vertebrates. And one more thing we have seen is various stages of embryonic development. Understand? So zygote is developing into morula, morula is developed into blastula, blastula to it is gastula. These are the various phases of embryonic development which is found in all the vertebrates. That's right. Embryology is also one of the very important tool for evidences of evolution. Understand? And we have one more tool for evolution evidence, that is paleontology. We will continue in next part.